fallen down because there's a lot more competition. This because Mars is actually competing at tournaments again.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, that's been fun. If I'm not mistaken, he's fifth New England PR right now. So, hey, if you want to see more Brawler action, shout outs to Apple Reviewer. eighth in the PR. I got that now.
Okay, so
anyway,
okay, we're getting the other side of winners, yeah. So yeah. Marvel, Donald J. Kong, and we are seeing the Steve game one, as you said earlier. Actually, I did see a bit of Marvel play the last time I actually commentated for the series, but I'm honestly really excited. Marvel's a really, really fun player to watch. I love watching a good Palu.
Absolutely. I mean, there's dozens of Palus, but I feel like every single Palu plays a little bit differently, and certainly interesting to see what they do that's unique, what makes them unique, what is their own spin on this very popular dish we call Palutena.
Marvel, from what I have noticed, is a very, like, aggressive sort of Palu, almost like Chase in that aspect. But, like, the way he plays is so, like, just interesting to commentate, I have to say. But,
yeah,
already, honestly, alright, right now, some really good pressure. This is a matchup that I have seen a lot, locally. And I'm honestly inclined to say that Palu does pretty well. I mean, it's top tier versus another top tier. You would hope it's even, but
yeah,
Palu's Palu's speed and just like how massive her aerials are, like back air and forward air, it did really good well at destroying blocks. But unfortunately, picking up the stock is a thing that she struggles with. But Steve does not. So
yeah, I'm thinking for Marvel in particular. The back air of Palutena, it does this great thing where Steve players love to set up walls and start mining behind them, and they just wait. They wait for you to try and break down the wall and attack them, because if you attack them, you're putting yourself in a disadvantage and they can react off the hit stun of it. With Palutena, because her back air and dash attack, this also does come into play for dash attack. Also, the entire time I've been explaining this, Marvel has lost another stock.
I was gonna say.
I like trying to explain the game, but sometimes the game just goes too fast. Anyway.
I mean, with a character like Steve, with the amount of zero deaths he have, like...
Yeah,
you have to get your senses up quick.
What I was getting at, though, is because you have these invincible back airs and dash attacks, you can actually put pressure on Steve's walls. And Steve, in a very rare instance, can't actually react off that and punish you for it. Instead, he kind of just has to hold the pressure. But speaking of holding pressure, Marvel is getting closer and closer to death's door the longer I talk about this, so I'm going to stop being a college professor and talk about the actual game happening instead.
Oh my gosh! Dude, I was... Okay, I was going to comment on this earlier, but he just, like, throws out these F smashes. It's really interesting. Like, a lot of Steve players are very patient with when they throw out kill moves, but definitely not Donald right here. He's just throwing this shit out. It's so interesting. He just, like...
I feel like there's this curve that you see. It's the bell curve that you usually see with it. There's a bunch of other characters you can apply it to. Where it's, I will F smash because it is strong. and Steve players definitely have that bell curve of, at lower levels, people are just going to throw it out willy-nilly. At mid-levels, people are going to be like, yeah, okay, I could F smash here, but I could also minecart, I could also up air, I could also do this, this, this. And then at top level, you go, Diamond Sword on forward smash is plus. I will F smash because it is strong.
Wait, is it actually?
I think it is, if I'm not mistaken. I will double check myself before I spread misinformation, but I'm pretty sure it's plus.
I would be shocked. That's so funny. Oh my gosh. And actually, right now, Marvel adding on a lot of this pressure early on to this stock, but still, again, struggling to close it out here. Something that I do see Palu struggle with a lot is trying to, like, she can get those damages to, like, or she can get those percents, like, really, really high with her really good early percent combo game and just really good ledge trapping, but she kind of struggles sometimes to close it out. Something that I see a lot of Palu players complain about, but able to get it out there, catching that neutral get up with that back air, and right now looking a lot better early on in this game, too.
Yeah, there's a little bit of Marthritis that comes up with Palutena, not to the same extent as some other characters, but Palutena, she does have the reliable options of her grab game, which is incredible, obviously, but she loses a lot of her natural combos, and that's kind of the thing that kills her. She does also have that spike, which is incredible. And if you, it's a one frame hitbox. So if you hit the hitbox, you know, you send them down under.
Let's see, actually. Oh my gosh. Really, like, had a really solid advantage, but just one Steve combo with a really good opening, and immediately it's now looking a lot more doable. But let's see, up tilt. Okay, trying to get for a stronger follow up there, only able to get two up airs. Got it? Not gonna be the stock just yet. This is so scary.
It always is. It always is in these tighter situations. Once you get up in higher percents, especially second stock, I feel is so crucial to get. You know, first stock obviously sets the momentum for the game. Second stock puts someone on the back foot, and it creates pressure for that person to then return the kill. But Marvell gonna use the wall against Donald J. Kong and just send in the explosive flames.
Also, I didn't even... I got distracted. I was looking at the Twitter handles. I didn't even realize that was Phantom. I just thought there was just another Steve player in New Jersey and just had, like, a random time. I was like, yeah, that sounds about right.
Yeah, no, it is Phantom as well.
Okay, good. Now I will not call them Donald J. Kong for the rest of the set.
Wow.
Don't get me wrong. Fire tag. Don't get me wrong. I think I will go insane if I have to repeat that.
No, it's great. What are you talking about?
My fault. Oh my, wait, okay. I was gonna say, Steve dash attack killing is something I don't see, like, ever.
It does every now and again. It's like, if it's a very back pocket kill move, but it is kind of a kill move. But also, explosive flame also just kind of kills like that.
Yeah, it does. As much as Palu can sometimes struggle to get, like, kill confirms, like, you do still have pretty solid kill moves, and explosive flame is absolutely one of them.
Yeah. So, also, I did look it up a little bit more specifically. Diamond is not plus on block, as I was spreading the misinformation of. It is minus 17. However, because of the pushback, it becomes a lot safer, to the point where it is effectively plus on block.
And also because it has a hitbox the size of God, I don't think anyone is going to punish that.
Yeah, and it chops like a third of your shield off. There's a lot of reasons why it's really good, and you can just kind of swing it for free.
Also, catching that roll out of shield there, that was a really good coverage right there from Phantom. But, I love seeing the way Palu, like some Palu players use down air, because it actually never spikes grounded, so you're always going to get that like sort of sour spot, like popping them up kind of thing. And a lot of Palu players, like, just using that for like really cool, like, grounded combo extensions, it's so raw.
Yeah. I feel like I always have character crises, but Palu is like one of the characters I was like, yeah, I played that in Smash 4. I should pick this character back up again. And then I go online to Elite Smash and get obliterated like that Anvil just did to Marvell.
I'm surprised he's alive. I mean, I guess Town and City, but Jesus, dude.
Yeah, you also got to see another good aspect of Palutena there versus Steve. Because Explosive Flame always acts on two set distances that you choose, nice kill with the forward air, you can bypass Steve walls. So if you don't want to challenge it, as you've seen Marvell doing with the background dash attack, you can instead just bypass it entirely by putting pressure on the Steve with the Explosive Flame.
I didn't even think about that, wow. Like, what, yeah, I said...
I forgot about that until I saw it come out.
I was gonna say, like, yeah, Palu, like, does really well at, like, going around, like messing up blocks or whatever, and I just assumed, like, yeah, just back your desk deck, what else do you need? And then I'm like, oh, explosive flame goes through that.
Yeah, you also have smaller things like the targeting reticle of auto reticle will go through the wall, which if there's a block that's about to break, you can kind of poke through. It does not deal damage to the blocks themselves. However, it is still an option.
So wait, was that a double teleport cancel? That was kind of cool. Oh my gosh. Phantom is absolutely trying to get the stock out of here as fast as possible.
Yeah, there it is. There's the swing. Dude, gold is minus 15 on S-Match, by the way.
That does not surprise me anymore, man. Gold is so good.
Like a tilt. It's an extra tilt.
Hey, but don't worry, it kills. Ooh, not gonna kill just yet. That's gonna do it.
Enough offstage pressure. Really good job at juggling things around there. Marvell looking very well poised at the moment.
So yeah, trying to poke outside with that forward air. Dash attack, still not gonna kill.
Town and City.
That is true. The stage, I think it does have some of the biggest blasts of legal stage. Wait, is Kalos legal in this rule set? I actually didn't look at that.
I don't believe it is. It's either Kalos or Town. Obviously, Hollow Bastion is also pretty big. That's kind of like the newer big stage that people keep going to.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my god!
Oh,
crazy spike to hit there!
That was insane!
We actually got that too.
I thought he was gonna go off the block. I'm surprised he was able to, like,
I feel like
around it.
That was the intention there, but just was DIing out to try and get away from further combos, I think, and fell past the block, which Steve can punish you for. Build a nice little bridge and block you off from getting back to the ledge.
That reacted, that was a really nice reaction. Already going immediately into that block in there, but oh no, Steve on FD. This is gonna be rough for most people.
Yeah.
You see
a lot of people who choose this stage as the counter pick, right? There's a lot of people who counter pick Steve to this stage. And I don't know why.
I don't think they know.
I do not think they know is the unfortunate reality, because FD for Steve, you know, the walk the dog combos that you already see, it's just easier now. The platforms that don't exist, Steve makes them. They do exist still.
And also another smaller fact that actually a Steve main did tell me about. When Steve mines for resources on this stage, he uses the shovel instead of pickaxe or axe on other stages. So that means he doesn't have to waste the durability of his other tools to get more resources.
Yeah,
so just another reason why the stage is so good for him.
I believe it is the other is the specific like terrain type that it is. And the only stages that use other that are legal, to my knowledge, are FD, the battlefields, and I think that's it.
I don't even think Battlefield. I think Battlefield is just iron. I could be wrong.
No, Battlefield, I believe, is other material as well. I will double check that, as I do many things.
Hey, that's good. I mean, I if either.
Wi-Fi go what?
Yeah, I thought mine did too for a minute.
Okay, we're back.
We're back. Also,
I got scared for a second. Everything just went silent, and I was like, uh-oh.
Yeah, I don't think it was either one of us, because even the stream got a little bit messed up. But anyways, Marvel doing surprisingly well for this being Steve on FD. Like, I think this honestly might have been a good play for him to go to Final Destination.
It is still a good stage for Palutena. I cannot... Wow, we just saw Stone forward smash kill.
That is not something you see very often. But, oh, breaking out of that combo with the up air and just, yeah, keeping her in the air like that. That's, oh, my God. These setups are so interesting, honestly, from Phantom.
Yeah.
Good much shifting right there. But, yeah, gonna get reversed with those. There's troops right there. And this is looking a little bit scary for Marvel. His lead is slipping by him just ever so slightly every second. Every interaction that he misses is just like another chance for Phantom to just make this back a little more. Oh my gosh! Dude, he is just spacing around these panic options from Phantom really, really well.
Yeah, it's a lot of good pressure being applied. That down tilt, gonna do a nice job, but Phantom has a lot of space to fight back from. Also, only has a few blocks to work with for resources here. Did just get the diamond, can craft that if the time is given, but the time will not be given. I kind of feel like Phantom wasn't really ready for that back air. I don't think that the eye was quite right there.
Yeah, I don't think so. I feel like he might have trying to been like drifting away, and then unfortunately got inputted as DI away when he got hit by that back air. So
yeah
that's gonna be rough, but
that's life.
Yeah. But still has another chance to get the set with a game 5 right now. And kinda interested to see what the counterpick is gonna be. Oh, going back to town. Okay, okay.
That makes sense. A lot of Steve mains do like the faster mining on this. It does, as somewhat alluded to previously, wear down the durability, but durability doesn't really matter as much when you can get so many resources back. Wow, Marvail making it back from some seriously good pressure from Phantom there.
Yeah, escaping like death's grip right there. Like that was, I made a pun. That was not intentional. But, you know, barely escaping that ledge trap right there, being able to make it back. Oh my, okay. I thought that back air was gonna kill there from another like unfortunate DI mistake, but right now, it's just a little bit scary.
Yeah, we've seen a really good turnaround from Marvail here, kind of making the set. You sometimes see sets that become very momentum-based, and Marvail has taken whatever momentum is in this set and just gone crazy with it. It feels like Donald J. Kong Phantom has not done much as of recent.
It's really interesting. Like, I don't know why. I feel like in his game plan, like, he's just been playing a lot more aggressive, which usually is really bad versus Steve because Steve is really good at, like, stopping approaches. But with the way that he's been using, like, Palu's, like, just giant disjoints with his normals, like, he's been, honestly, been making this aggressive style of play really, really work for him.
Yeah, and I love the couple of reflectors and counters that keep coming out to deal with these minecarts and anvils. It's a lesser-used tool, but Palutena having access to both of those things is something that can affect matchups, and you'll see it come out sometimes in situations like this, even if Palu players don't really use it, because it is kind of one of the worst reflectors and counters in the game.
Yeah, and you know, it is a good tool to have, but unfortunately, being the like a pretty mediocre move and already pretty mediocre like style of move isn't exactly a good thing.
Palu got the reflector counter before anyone else did, and so they were like, okay, because we're giving her both, we need to make this not good. And then they gave it to every single other DLC character and also just base roster character in Ultimate and went, yep, that seems right.
They were like, I think it's kind of broken to be given a character a counter and a reflector in the same move, and then Joker got made.
Yeah. But even like K-Rool had that in base.
Yeah, I didn't even think about that. I mean, at least K-Rool sucks, so we don't have to see it that much, but Paulo was a very... Joker and Paulo were both very, very broken.
And then they also gave it to Sora? Sora's counter is a reflector for some reason? I've never understood that.
This game was... I don't think this game was playtested, but...
This game was designed by kindergartners.
You know what? It's beautiful.
And I love it. I love it all the more for it.
Oh my... Okay.
Oh, wow. The rare instance of Steve having no resources. Yeah, Marvail going to be able to apply a ton of pressure to that. And there goes Phantom down into loser's side to face somebody. Greg House, apparently.
Oh, Greg House. Rob. Oh, it's going to be a really fun set. Rob Steve is a really interesting set to watch, personally.
Yeah, an update on the other side of losers. Beady Bean beat Yeast 3-0, securing a spot in loser's finals. Or Ooh. Semifinals. Loser semis. Don't come for me.
Dude, I think Beady Bean might be real, actually. This is crazy.
He might be real. If he wins this, he might be real.
Let's see. Oh, he's actually looking at the seeded path. He is actually seeded to play Phantom right after that. So, Wario Steve, that's going to be rough, but I believe in him. I believe in the
dog. Wario, you say?
Yeah.
Oh, what? Right. Sorry. I'm stupid. I was thinking Yeast.
Oh, look, I'm sure Wario would go crazy.
My brain confused Wario Hat Me Brawler with Wario.
It's like when people use the Crom Me Sword Fighter. It's like, yeah, what do you mean? Crom's
yeah,
already
yeah. in the game. Guys, Crom's been in the game since Smash 4, don't you know?
Yeah, I'm a Crom main.
Yeah, and Doom Guy's in the game. Sans Undertale.
If only.
I love how the Sans Undertale model was also the most high quality me gunner costume that ever came out, so there was genuine speculation about whether or not Sans was like a DLC in development and they repurposed the